Hello everybody, and welcome to yet another Anne Boleyn video. I know I said in the last Joe Laurie video that I wouldn't be doing another Joe Laurie exposure video or any kind of dealings with Joe Laurie. At least, in the description, I made a reference that I wouldn't be doing any more Joe Laurie content. But unfortunately, 21 hours ago, I have been proven wrong. I have to now react to it, because Joe Laurie did upload recently, which adds more fuel to the fire, but we'll get on to that in a moment. So, as you can see here, we have Anne Boleyn Reid here, and I typed in her name and filtered it by channel, because I was doing a bit of a search randomly to see if there's any more burner accounts that she has. And the thing is, as I was scrolling down, I found some hilarious troll accounts here. Some of them are just detractors that, you know, report on Amber. But then you have this one, Amber Space Reed. Now, the interesting thing is, I thought to myself, what happens if I type in Amber Reed? Because there was a time when she was referred to as just Amber Reed, as opposed to Anne Boleyn Reid. I think there was actually a gimmick where she dropped the Lynn part and just went with Amber Reed. Or did she drop the Anne Boleyn, then the Reed part, and just call herself Anne Boleyn? She was basically scared of some adult film actress suing her into the ground or something. It was a very, very specific arc. And it lasted for like less than a month. If you'd blink, you'd miss it. Much like everything else, really. So we're going to click filter, and we're going to go to channel, right? So here, you have Amber Reed and Amber Reed's new account. They both have the same amount of subs near enough. This one's a bit short, but, you know, they're in the same bracket. So we're going to click on this channel. And this one has very specific content on it. A doorway, sometimes a wall, sometimes another doorway with different lighting. But the lighting in the lighting in most of them seems to be kind of the same, unless it's a bit dark and possibly the person uploading the degeneracy, I guess you could say, maybe adding a filter, or possibly having the light switched off, I guess, during the day, because that can happen when you turn a light off in a room and the sun shining through it, the lighting looks different. So naturally, I'm under the impression that this is Amber's, like, strange account where she's catering to the weird fetish side of YouTube, the complete degenerates that get off on stuff like this. So naturally, we're going to sort these by popular, and we're going to go to the most popular video. Of course, we have this one with this title, because Anne Boleyn gotta be classy, right? Especially with this channel. I'm not going to let you listen to this, because I want to save everybody's ears. I don't want anyone to suffer what I've suffered when I actually looked at this. So let me go down to the comments section. So somebody said, is this Anne Boleyn, like, our goal? And then somebody put like a meme as a response there, so I'm not really sure what to make of that. But I am going to give them a thumbs up, because they asked a valid question. And of course, naturally, we have degenerate comments that are getting off on this, which is just strange to me, really. Do people find this attractive? That's exactly what I thought when I was reading this. It sounds like an animal taking a piss. She is such an animal. Amber is, I'm afraid. At least, allegedly, it's Amber. So, the interesting thing is, a YouTube user by the name T-Queen actually did report on this. They reported on Amber basically catering to this type of audience. Unfortunately, I think the channel either moved on and had the video taken down, or the channel maybe got wiped from YouTube, I'm not too sure. I didn't really look into it too much, but I'm sure it was either Tea Queen or maybe Trash Queen or someone. It was some detractor in the smaller circles that did report on this. They actually did put a video out there theorizing that this could be Amber. And the thing is, they didn't report on this channel. This one is actually older than the other one they reported on. The one they actually reported on was the Amber's second account, which we'll get to in a moment. Of course, naturally me, being me, I put a good old wholesome comment down, because I just have to, of course. So here we are going to find the Amber Reed account again, the second one that was reported on by Tea Queen at the time. This is Amber Reed's new account. And would you know it, it's been active a week ago. Coincidentally coinciding with the Disappearance Act that Amber has pulled recently and turned into Joe Laurie / actual fetishist channel, I guess. That seems to be her game right now. Another interesting rumor I did hear is that her channel got demonetized, at least her main channel. Now, I think you need a certain amount of subs and viewership to monetize. So I don't really know what the end game is for this, whether she's like uploading to probably get to the AdSense program with this account, if it is her, as like an alternate way of making money off complete degenerates, I guess. So, we're gonna go to her most recent video. I'm not watching this video and I've already disliked it. I've put my comment down on here because, you know. The Colouring Books, the Binge, and the Dot to Dot Books. You've been doing weird fetish videos so you can capture the feeders and degens. That's roughly what it seems to me. But the interesting part about this channel is that if you look at the most of the vids, it scrolls down. Right, let me go to the most popular video. Yes, here we go. This is the main point I'm making. They're the exact same door and flooring, with almost the same lighting. Exactly almost. So, it begs the question, is this really Amber on, like, some weird fetish channel? Because only Amber would make an alternate channel that captures a complete degenerate market like this. Dump one of the accounts and move on to another account and be active on that one. Because she goes through accounts like anybody's business. If she's not on her Amber Lynn channel, she's probably on this account. I don't think she's on the other account, I think she probably long ago abandoned that one for whatever reason. But then you have accounts like Joe Laurie, which just exist to bait people. There was a part of me that thought that maybe that Joe Laurie is a complete troll and they're working people. But I don't think they are. I legit think it is Amber doing this. On top of that, you've got other accounts like Chris Wainwright, for example, who is another White Knight of Ambers, who coincidentally doesn't have any videos uploaded or that many subs, but yet, whenever Amber's being hated on, as they say, or being called out for her bullshit and complete bunch of excuses for basically not keeping to any level of consistency, that account is always there defending her most of the time. So it just begs the question that, you know, this has to be Amber. I also referenced, I'll just like my own comment because why not, I'll be a scrub. But I also referenced the two accounts as well. Just to put things on meat hooks, as it were. So, before I go as well, naturally, Joe Laurie, I like to think of Joe Laurie net right now as kind of this channel's lesser nemesis, I guess you could say. Kind of like a rival of sorts. in a healthy way, of course. But they uploaded a video a few hours back, and I did say in the last Joe Lorre exposure video I did that I wouldn't be doing any more Joe Lorre stuff, at least in the description, I believe. I might have said it in the video, I'm not entirely sure. But after realizing that they uploaded, I couldn't really help myself. I was like, I wonder if this really is a troll, or if it is Amber. So let's go to the account. There's also a few extra discoveries that I actually made between the exposure video I did and the other exposure. To give a bit of frame of reference, this one was recorded way ahead of time compared to this one, of course, which was, you know, made more recent. And I did say in that one that I'd upload the old video, which is what I did. So here we have, I mean, that's another thing too, at least I'm upfront and I don't put pre-recorded in brackets in my video, in my video, title, I guess. I think I actually just, oh no, I did put old video, but I didn't put pre-recorded. I just put old video because it is. So I click on Joe Lorre. Now the interesting thing is that most people already know this, but for those who don't, I'll quickly mention it. That Joe Lorre is essentially, it's Lindsay Lohan's mugshot. Like, legitimate, 100%. If you type in Lindsay Lohan mugshot, this is what pops up. I'll actually look it up just to prove it, I guess, but like, it's already been mentioned and reported, people already know about it. The biggest irony is that, like, you know, she's using Lindsay Lohan's mugshot, and Amber's mother was basically a former jailbird. Which is just beautiful irony. I couldn't write much more beautiful irony myself if I tried, to be honest. I mean, that's just comedic gold that writes itself in terms of context. Also, another interesting point to note, and you will probably have noticed it, or maybe not actually, is that in the Google search section, I have Lorre's garlic salt here. Which is another interesting thing that got brought up. And I wouldn't know this because I've not heard of Lorre's garlic salt before. But it turns out that this is Amber's brand, as it were. It's kind of her go-to for garlic salt. So I just thought that was an interesting observation. I can't remember who brought it up, but somebody in my comments did. If you're watching you were the person that referenced it, thank you very much, because I wouldn't have caught on to that if you hadn't brought it up. So I'm giving you props to you for this entire segment slash kind of situation, moment type thing right here, right now. So here we're going to go to the new video. It's only 6 seconds long. It's called Halloween Things, Tongue Poking Out Emoji. I'm wondering if that's a reference to the chocolate cake pop thing that she did where she, like, bobbed her tongue out. I think I'll have to clip that and upload it at some point, because that was just, an opportunity I couldn't pass up. I mean, in terms of lulziness and ridiculousness of the situation. It's laughable, very sad at the same time. So let's click on here. So here, I'm going to pause. We have Reese's, Big Cups, Twix's, brown packet, which I cannot make the writing out of. It looks like some kind of chocolate. A big gummy sweet, which is red and black. I'm assuming that could be red licorice, black licorice kind of thing. And I'm not sure what that is. It looks like some sort of gummy bug. The description says, I wish you all could enjoy this candy with me. It has 29 dislikes and 2 likes. And of course, we have our good old comment section right here. I'll sort these by newest. Once again, not showing your face. Second like. Somebody actually did give a like. Is this person a troll or any other reason? Once again, trolling back at it with the useless content. Amber Girl, those sweets can't be good for you. Becky, is that you or is it Amber? I'm giving people here likes because most of this is very interesting, and some of these are valid questions. Some of them are just complete troll comments, but it's funny either way. I'm going to quickly leave a comment down. Probably made a bunch of spelling mistakes, but I usually do when I type out comments. I'll just quickly double check them. It's capital L. There we go. I'm sure I commented a few times back, and I guess those got deleted. So. We'll never let Hamber silence us, I guess, as they say. So I'm going to do one more interesting thing just to hammer my point home. I did say that it was Lindsay Lohan, and why not? I may as well show it here. I can even find the matching picture if I look hard enough. Here we go. This picture right here. So, there we go. I've pretty much shown off everything there is to know about this weird account, and it's definitely not a troll account. It definitely has to be Amber trying hard to bait people. I mean, she's... I don't know what her end game is in all of this, other than to get reactions and comments from people or something, and then come back and maybe have some new personality that she's gonna adopt. I guarantee you somewhere she has like some new vlogger that she's been watching, and she's probably gonna copy their personality, because 9 times out of 10 she does. But until then, I guess, carry on doing your stupid trolling, Amber, and whatever the video is next that you're gonna be putting out, I guess I'll watch and maybe do some sort of reaction, but you're pretty much exposed at this point now, ridiculously. It's getting sad, to be honest, because you're getting to that point where you're having to do absolutely anything to get a reaction, and you think that by burying your head in the sand on one of these weird burner accounts and thinking that you can get a reaction and then come back and act like you haven't done anything and that you've had some sort of she's gonna have some sort of dramatic story, probably, if I had to guess, because this is Amber we're talking about. When she takes a long break from something, she has to add something dramatic in there. But hey, I'm gonna get called a no-life hater who has no life, apparently. I mean, yeah, these videos are a bit on the long side, but editing them and posting them doesn't really take me that long. I mean, the whole you have no life argument is pretty much dated at this point. Like, anybody can make a video within 20 minutes, post it online, and then do a gazillion other things, because you know how many hours are in a day? 24 hours, Amber. So, hey, how about you, I guess? And carry on doing your binging. I'm sure it will end well for you, because, of course, it ended so well for you when you did the video where you were basically, you know, crying and trying to get as much sympathy as much as possible. In fact, I'm actually going to play that video out now to be massively ironic, because I think it's very fitting. It's almost, it's fitting even more with how pathetic you've become, essentially. I think it's the proof video, the here's your proof video. Yeah, we're gonna play this out.
Hey guys, so I just woke up. I really haven't been wanting my vlogs to be like a negative space. I don't cry anymore. It's really weird. I used to cry all the time, and it's like, I mean, I would cry a few times a day, and it's like, I don't cry anymore. So the fact that I'm like tearing up and I'm feeling, I'm hurt, you know? I get a lot of hate online, obviously. And it's like, I'm able to accept.
She gets a lot of hate online, acting like she never does anything wrong, by the way.
Out a wide range of hate, I'm really truly able to, but when people come at me with things like this and sit there and tell me that my cancer was fake and is fake and the journey I went on was fake, it is unbelievable. It is literally unbelievable. I'm strong.
And the reason why people said that this shit was fake is because she acts fake most of the time. Like, if she acts fake, then what was she expecting? For people to just... It's like the old saying, if you cry wolf enough, eventually people are not going to care. And that's exactly what happened. You bit the hand that feeds you multiple times, and oh boy, did you bite the hand that feeds you multiple times. You've done it on so many occasions.
I've been through hell in the last 3 months. And I'm so tired of having to prove myself repeatedly and constantly. And this is like so personal and private. If you want your proof, here's your proof. Here's an actual medical record. And if you can't read, I'll read it to you. This is from my health portal where I'm able to sign in and see all of my results, summaries of my appointments. I don't know.
Nobody was asking her to do this. She did this just to get as much sympathy as possible. Just to get the pity dollars, as they say. Anything to make herself look like a victim. Even though 9 times out of 10, she instigates most of the shit that she brings on to herself. If you treat yourself like shit, you're gonna end up having shit caused in your body like that. It's common knowledge, really.
How to pronounce big doctor words. So, excuse me. This 29-year-old... I'm sorry, this is pathetic.
This is pathetic. That statement of past Amberlynn saying that this is pathetic, that's exactly how I feel when she does the Joe Lori shit. Like, it is pathetic. It's beyond pathetic at this point. It's gotten to the point where it's no longer a game, but rather just a complete clown fest where everyone's laughing. It was already a clown fest to begin with, but it's become an entire circus and then some since then.
29-year-old presents today for follow-up after total abdominal hysterectomy, bilateral salpingo oophorectomy on July 15th, 2020. With final pathology showing stage 1B, grade 2, endometrial cancer. She had a CT scan.
See, that little look towards the camera, that's where we're supposed to feel sorry for her. Because, you know, someone treating their body like shit got cancer. Like, who knew, you know? But that look, this look here, she's supposed to be like, oh, you gotta feel sorry for me now, audience, because I'm emotionally manipulating you all. Like, no, you put yourself in this position. No one else. You were the one that openly wanted to do mukbangs and sit down and eat yourself to death and make money off of it.
I'm sorry, I'm just like... She had a CT scan earlier today showing stable abdominal and retroperitoneal endonopathy. I'm sorry, I can't pronounce these things. And the background part, it just talks about, you know, why I ended up going to the ER and the whole situation with that.
Yeah, the way you handled getting your cancer was just very, very undignified. Also, the pictures of the bloody toilet on your I think it was on your Instagram or your Snapchat. Very classy. Because that's exactly what people do when they're suffering from stuff like that. They post it online to get as much of a reaction out of people as possible, or at least sympathy. Absolutely pathetic.
It's like, I don't know how much more proof people want from me. This is real, and it happened, and I've had to struggle with it, and it's been fucking terrifying.
Oh yeah, cancer is no joke, is it? It's no joke. It's also no joke when you're making up rape allegations on someone and then trying to pass that off as an actual thing that happened. It's like they say, karma has a funny way of getting back at you.
It's like, I can fucking handle the hate, but when it comes to this, it does hurt me, and you...
It hurts you that a couple of people online made some videos that were considered a bit mean. Cry me a fucking river. There's plenty of people that are doing that more so. There's people in comment sections calling you out on shit. But yet, you act like you get hurt by that all the time. But yet, in one video, you say you're strong and nothing can faze you, but the next minute, you're crying like a little bitch like this. So which one is it, Amber? Are you strong or are you weak? Which one? I definitely know it's not strong, that's for sure.
Haters, I fucking hate that word. Have won. You guys have hurt me, and I hope that you're happy. I'm sure you get a kick out of seeing me like this. I hate that I have to sit here and show such personal freaking stuff that not even people in my...
Nobody asked you to show this stuff, by the way. Nobody asked you. It's the way you handled it and the way you went about it that people have a problem with. More than anything else. It was very undignified what you were doing. Not gonna lie.
My life I've gotten to read. Obviously it's information I share, but it's just like... These are
And there you go. It's information you've shared. That's the difference. You chose to share it. No one told you to. You could have just simply kept quiet and ignored it. It's like... You know, it's like some people say some absolutely outlandish stuff about people, really. But most people ignore that. I mean, heck, even the fetish channels that I mentioned earlier, I mean, at best, they might not be Amber, as far as we know. But it looks likely. I mean, who else makes accounts and then dumps them and moves on to a similar account doing the same stuff? With barely changing anything. Heck, you even said yourself in many videos that you just pick thumbnails that are auto-generated by YouTube.
Medical records. I don't want to be known as someone who's lying about having cancer. It's disgusting. There's already so many other rumors about me that is just, like, unbelievable. And it's just, like... I have no proof for those other things, and it's so much that I am pinned out to be someone that isn't even real. Like, you guys see me as someone that isn't even real, and it's like there's...
And the reason they see you as someone that isn't even real, because you act fake most of the time. Most of your personalities are copied from other people, or you take certain traits of your current partners. No wonder people call you out saying you don't have a personality. Also, the fact that you're a giant manipulator just also adds more fuel to the fire.
There's a whole other version of me that you guys don't know or won't accept or truly see for themselves. But there you go. You got your medical proof.
We got the medical proof. No one asked for it, really. Oh well, fuck it. It doesn't matter. I'm done. Here anyway, and I'm also done with this video for now. If Joe Lurie uploads again, maybe I'll report on it. It depends on what level of bait it is. If it's completely... If it's below the sweets level in terms of expectations, then I probably won't bother with it. Well, I'm out. I'll see you guys in whatever videos next, I guess.